Let us discuss the clock angle question. So in this question, the main idea is to calculate the angle difference between the minute and hour and. Here, we are also given with a formula to calculate the Indian standard time. Let's say for example, if the longitude mentioned in the question is 82.5 degree, and if the earth rotation is for 24 hours per day, then IST is equal to 24 by 360 into 82.5, so which is 5.5 hours. So we are 5.5 hours ahead of UTC. So if you want to calculate Indian standard time from UTC, then you will have to add 5.5 hours. So this is the basic idea, but the main idea of this question is to calculate what is the angle difference between the hour and the minute hand. Now let's look into the constraints. So whatever be the time, we'll have to mention the time difference on clock with 12 hour clock, irrespective of period of Earth's rotation. So input format will be like period of Earth rotation in hours, which is generally 24. And the second one is value of longitude up to 2 decimal points. So they'll also give us the longitude and the period of Earth rotation. Output is the smallest angle between the hour and minute hand, which shows the difference between time at a particular longitude and time at UTC up to 2 decimal places. Let's say for example 24, 82.5. So we have already know that this will give us 5.5 hours. So if the time is 5:30, you'll have to find out what is the angle difference between 5, the hand 5 or the hour hand 5 and the minute hand 30. So that is how we ended up with 15 degrees. So we'll look into it in detailed manner. So the basic idea is, first you have to calculate what is the IST, and then you will have to calculate what is the hour hand and the minute hand pointing to, and then you will have to find out the angle difference between these two things. So here this is 15 degree. Now let's understand how to find the angle difference. So it's already given that we'll have to use 12 hour clock, right? So this formula is already given. So with this formula, we'll get this value, whatever hash we have to find out. That means for whatever time we'll have to find out the angle difference, we'll get it from this formula, right? So if we get the earth rotation hash and the longitudinal degrees, then we'll be able to get this time. So the basic idea is to get the angle difference between the hour and minute from the value that we obtained from the result of this formula, isn't it? Now, so to get the hours from the given value, we simply take only the values from the decimal point. That is, for example, if it's, it won't return as 530, it will return like 5.5. So 5.5 is nothing but 530, right? So in order to get the hours, so if it's 5.5, this will represent the hour and this will represent the minute, isn't it? So to get the hour, you will simply take the integer part of the entire thing. So int hour is equal to int of clock time. So assume this is a clock time. So integer part of clock time would be saved in h, that is 5 would be saved. Now to calculate minutes, we know that clock time is 5.5. So when I subtract 5.5 or 5 from 5.5, I'll end up with 5. Sorry, 0.5. So 5.5 minus 5 will give us 0.5. 0.5 into 10. Why we are making it into 10? Because it's in decimal. So I'm just multiplying it with 10. So I'll end up with 5. And then when I again multiply it with 6, I'll get 30. So this can be applied for any of the decimal values for converting it into proper minutes. So here it would become 30. Now if you read, it would be like 5:30, a proper timing. So with this formula, I'm converting the decimal into proper minutes. Now, after you have found out what is the hour and the minute from the IST result, now we'll have to check the angle difference, right? So for that, there is a small calculation. I'll briefly explain how this calculation works. you can have a paper and pencil with you in order to trace it. Okay, so can you tell me in how many hours the her hand will trace this 360 degree together? So you know that the total angle inside a circle is equal to 360 degree, isn't it? So assume the her hand is here, and after how many hours will it trace this entire 360 degree? 12 hours, yes. So by the end of 12 hours, it traces 360 degrees. So for 12 hours, if it's tracing 360 degree, then for 1 hour, it should be 360 by 12, right? Yes. For every hour, the hour hand is actually tracing 30 degrees inside the circular clock. So if it's 5 hours, that is if it's 5 o'clock, then the angle traced by this hour hand would be like 5 into 30, which is equal to 120 approximately. We still have a lot of minor things inside this angle calculation, but as of now, roughly you understand that for every hour, the hour hand is making a 30 degree movement. So for every hour, if it's making 30 degree, then for 60 minutes, it's 30 degree, right? So 1 hour, 30 degree. So you can make it like for 60 minutes, it's 30 degree. So for 1 minute, it would be half degree, isn't it? So for every minute, it is moving half degree. So to make things clear, I'll just explain once. Her hand will take 12 hours to trace this 360 degrees entirely. If it's 12 hours for 360 degree, then for 1 hour, it would be 360 by 12, which is equal to 30 degree. That means for every hour, her hand will move 30 degrees. So if for every hour, if it's 30 degree, then for every minute, how much would be the degree? Let's say, if for every hour, if it's 30 degree, that is 60 minutes, it's equal to 30 degree. That means 1 minute is equal to 30 by 60, which is equal to half degree. So her hand moves 30 degree per hour and half degree per minute. Now with that note, let's try to calculate it for minutes. So for minute hand, how many minutes will it take to trace this 360 degree? So for every hour, the minute hand will move 360 degrees, isn't it? That means for every hour, if it's 360 degree, so these things are for, these two things are for hour hand. So minute hand traces 360 degree in 1 hour or 360 degree in 60 minutes. So 60 minutes is equal to 360 degrees. So 1 minute is equal to 360 by 60, which is equal to 6 degree per minute. So for every minute, it is tracing 66 degrees. Okay. So all these things we have discussed so far. So let me quickly keep these two things only. So for 1 hour, it is 30 degree, and for 1 minute, it is half degree for hour hand. And 1 minute, it is equal to 6 degree per minute hand. We need not think about seconds as of now. If you think about seconds, then it would be like for every minute it is tracing 360 degree. Therefore 60 seconds is equal to 360 degree, and the calculation goes on. Now we are bothered about only the minute and the hour part. So with this, let's discuss. Yes. Now with this, let's try to write a formula for the same. So let me take this 5:30 only. Okay, so for 5:30, I'll tell you how we ended up with 15 degrees. Okay, so first let's calculate for hour hand. So we know that for every hour it is 30 degree. So I'm going to write h is equal to 5 and m is equal to, this we have already done using some formulas, so I'm just going to write m is equal to 30. Now let's try to calculate what is the total angle that's traced by the hour hand from, assume this is my 0 degree. So from 0, I'm going to calculate what is the total angle that has been traced by hour hand. Okay. So how to do that? So for every hour, it is 30 degree. So we know that h is the hour. I'm just writing it in a generalized manner, or we'll do this later. One second. Right. So 5 into 30, right? Because for every hour, if it's 30 degree, then for 5 hours, it would be 5 into 30 plus for every minute, it is half degree. So when the minute hand is moving for 30 minutes, that time also our hand would have moved sometimes degrees, right? So that I'm going to calculate. So 30 for every minute, if it's half degree, then for 30 minutes it would be 30 into 1 by 2. So this is the total angle that's been traced by the hour hand. So 5 into 30, it would be 5 threes are 15, isn't it? So 150 plus 30 into half. So it would be 15 again. So what is the total angle traced by the hour hand in this case? 150 plus 15, it is equal to 165. Now we are done with hour hand calculation. Now let's go for minute hand. I'll just write it as H here. And for minute hand, again, so we have 30 minutes, isn't it? So we already told that for every minute hand will move 6 degrees. So for 30 minutes, it would be equal to 30 into 6, which is equal to 180. So the difference between the hour hand and the minute hand. Now can you calculate? It's very simple. So it's equal to 180 minus 165, which is equal to 15 degrees. Yes. Now let's try to arrive in a generalized formula irrespective of this 5:30 and things like that. I'll just rub it quickly. Done. So let's try to find the generalized formula. So what you will do for hour hand calculation, we'll be going like whatever hour is there, we'll be multiplying it with 30. Plus for every minute, right? So for every minute, we'll have it in M into half. So this would be my total hour hand movement. So, and then for minute, so for every minute, it would be like M into 6. So this is my total minute hand calculation. So let's take it as H and let's take this as M. That's it. So now, you'll have to find out what is the difference between H and M. When I say difference, there are chances where H might be greater or M might be greater. So, whatever is having greater value, you will have to simply subtract the former value from the previous one. That's it. So, this is all about the angle calculation. Now, let's try to write the pseudocode of this thing. So, first, let's get the input values and then calculate the IST by the given formula in the question. And then calculate the angle difference between the hour and the minute hand. So, we have already discussed how to calculate the difference between hour and minute hand. So, you can use your own formula to find the angle difference. Once that is done, you will have to simply print the angle difference with 2 decimal points precision. That's it, guys. Let us discuss the solution for clock angle question. We have already gone through the coding or question part of the clock angle, along with its constraints, input, output and sample test cases as well. Now let's get started with the coding. I am choosing C++. You can choose any of your convenient languages to code because the pseudocode and the logic part would be the same for all the programming languages. Let's get started. So generally we'll start with variable declaration. So here I have declared an integer and a float. Basically two float values. So one is to get the longitude and the other one is to get the time. So if you look at the input, we'll have to take the longitude part and the value to calculate the Indian standard time, right? So that is the reason why I have taken both the things. Let's get it from the user. Done. Now float. Now I'll have to take the period of rotation. I'm converting the period into float, so using PR means typecasting with float. Now let's calculate the time. Time is equal to, this formula is already given, so let's quickly do that. Period of rotation divided by 360.00 or 0, anything would do, into longitude is already taken as input into 60. Done. Now let's try to get the value of h. H is equal to, I'm going to simply typecast it to integer to get only the integer part of the value of time. So int of time by 60, because we have multiplied it with 60 over here, and m is equal to, done. Now we'll have to calculate the hand rotation. See, we have already discussed this part. So h mod 12. So even if it's 24 hours timing, then we'll have to divide it by 12 to check the actual time in 12 hours clock. So that is also done. So I'm going to make it as float m is equal to m only, the direct minutes. There's no change in the minute hand, even if it's a 24 hour clock. Now let's try to find the angle. So angle would be definitely in float. So I'm just writing float angle is equal to, so 11 by 2. So this formula, we have got it by deriving the hour and minute hand angle in the general terms. So you can simply go through the concept video. So 11 by 2 m minus 30 h is the basic formula to calculate the angle between the minute and the hour hand. So we'll have to check if angle is less than 0. If it's less than 0, then you will have to add plus 360 to it, because I'm trying to subtract minute from hour, right? So there are chances where the minute hand is lesser than the hour hand. Let's say, for example, 5:15. So the minute hand is before the hour hand. So if I try to subtract, you will get the value in negative. So and in that case, I'll have to add 360 to it. So that's what I'm doing. Since in the question, it's clearly given that you'll have to round it off to two decimal points. I'm just making it as set precision of angle plus 360. Now, whenever you are using set precision, what we'll have to do? We'll have to include the header file, that is IO manipulation. So I'm just quickly doing that as well. So we have written 0 here. We'll have to return 0 because we have used int main. Done. Now I have to include a header file. I'll quickly do that. Done. Now it's time for us to save and compile. We'll quickly check. We have taken the period, we have taken longitude, and we have declared something called as time. We have taken the period and longitude, and then we'll have converted it to float, have tried to calculate the time, and then taken h and m, and then trying to calculate the angle and printing the same. That's what we have done. We'll try to save and compile. Okay, we have got some errors. Okay, the mistake is very simple. Here I have used capital O. Here I have used small o. That is a mistake. I'll just quickly save and compile. So as you can see, all the test cases are cleared. So this is all about the solution part of clock angle question. We'll meet you in the next.
Hey YouTube, how are you doing? Stay tuned to Facebook for more awesome videos. Don't forget to subscribe.